When the problem with the devil. And the problem with you, that, amen, that you need to make up in your mind that you're going to defeat the thing that's trying to defeat you. You're going to make up in your mind that you're going to conquer that devil. Can you say amen again? That's coming against you, coming against your home, coming against your life, coming against your job. You're going to defeat that devil, praise God. So he gave you a shield to get out there and fight. And you're going to be a winner. You got to tell yourself you're going to win. If you're not a fighter, amen, knowing you're going to be a loser, you might as well give up now. But you need to go in that fight knowing that you're going to be a winner. Devil, I know I'm going to conquer you. I know I'm going to get the victory over you, praise God. Amen. That's why you got this shield of devil, eh? Praise God, shield of protection. Then give a shield for the back, amen. You know what the thing, the most important thing you always remember. Praise God, your front is the most, what the devil wants the most. He want to mess around with your heart. He want to destroy your heart. He want to destroy your lungs. He want to destroy your top and front part of your body. Can you say amen again? No, you got a shield, amen, to conquer that devil, praise God. Then you get a heaven of salvation. You got to turn your head. How many know we have a head problem? How many know the devil, amen? Praise God. All the battles that you lose is in your mind. And all the battles you win is going to be in your mind. Now, have you ever thought about that? All the battles that you lose is in your mind. If you lose it in your mind, you're going to lose it naturally and spiritually. So. And all the battle that you win is going to be a mind battle. A mind battle. That's why the devil don't mess with you, amen, when you're in a crowd. He waits till you get alone and mess with your mind. He goes, amen. That's why you need faith, amen. He said, praise God, to stand against the devil because he comes against your mind. If he can confuse your mind, if he can get you to start doubting God, start dealing with unbelief in your mind, praise God, it's going to get in your heart. If it get in your mind, it get in your heart. If it get in your heart, you're automatically a loser. Hey, you say amen again. Amen. So the devil, everything that you had to come up against first comes to your mind. Something you're thinking about. Something you meditate on. Amen. Thing that keeping you woke in your mind. Amen. You wrathful with that problem. You couldn't sleep last night. You're wrathful with that problem. Amen. The devil is vexing you in your mind, praise God. And every time you get alone, you're thinking about it, he's still vexing you, still tormenting you. Praise God. So the number one thing you had to come, amen, praise God. And Paul said, being transferred by the renewing of your mind. Yeah. Got to get something done to your mind. Yeah. Right? Oh, yeah. You got to get something done to your mind. I mean, a lot of times that's where it is, because you say, well, you know, I'm thinking about how I was going to do it. I'm thinking about that liquor, how I was going to drink it. I'm thinking about that sex, how I was going to do it, you know? That's in the mind. Can you say amen again? That's why you got to defeat the devil from your mind. Can you say amen? Drive him out. Get rid of your enemy, praise God. Amen. Evil always comes to the mind. That's why he said, give you a heaven for your mind. Give you heaven for your head. Amen. And then take the spirit of the word. Take the spirit of the word. Take the word. Can you say amen again? Because, amen, when you know, amen, faith come by hearing, and hearing come by what? The word. Faith come by hearing, and hearing come by the word, praise God. Amen, praise God. You need to know what the word said, praise God. That's why he said, praise God, stand there for having your own gullible with truth. Mike, having some truth. Knowing what the Bible says, glory to God. Amen. The only reason why those Hebrew boys were able to stand because they had truth. All the way from Daniel walked in the lounge and walked out, praise God. Amen. He knew about what God said and what God could do, praise God. He believed that God was able to deliver him, amen, from the lions, amen. Praise God. Nobody had ever been delivered from lions. That was a certain thing they always did when they had a way of punishing folks, amen. The lion did was a breath-breathing thorn. The lion with him. That's how you do. They'll always have some kind of scare. You see what I'm saying? So men, amen, that you kind of got contrary, amen, to the law, amen, of the king. They been saying, so you didn't allow me. Yeah. See, but Daniel, amen, knew how that thing was coming out. Mm-hmm. Because, honey, he was praying three times a day. Yeah. When you pray three times a day, the devil can't eat you. Amen. The lion don't have an appetite for you. And you say, amen, again. I don't care why they put you in. You bring your knees three times a day, and they ain't got no appetite, but you pray to God. And Daniel knew how that day was coming out before they even put him in there. Uh-huh. Yeah. You always know how things coming out. Don't care what you're going up against, you know whether you're going cooking or not. Even if you're out there going to buy a car, you know, you know, amen, you ain't going to get that car before you get there. You already know it. But you just gone down there just to be going. But you could have went back home because you knew you were going to get it. You just knew that this was not the right day for you. I guess that's where faith was, praise God. That's why, amen, gave us faith. Because, amen, on another day you woke up with faith on your mind. Knowing what you're going to do when you get left home. You know, you knew that you were going to get exactly what you wanted when you got out there. Because this is the day that you acted something on the inside of you. You were bucking over. You couldn't get waiting to get where you were going. Because you simply believed that you were going to get what you wanted. And that's where faith always works, you know. Can you say amen again? One day you get up, amen, thinking you got it, and then you're not really in it that day. But at the time you get up, and you just feel like you can conquer anything right now. And amen, anything. My Lord, amen, I don't care how big the devil is, how big you get in your way, you're going to conquer him. Hallelujah. Yeah. You feel like you can cast out devils, amen, now, praise God. Amen. But I'm here to tell you, amen, that a shield of faith. You got a shield to protect you. Yeah. Amen. Faith is to protect you from your enemy. Faith is a shield, amen, and stay, praise God. When you go against your enemy, the devil cannot, amen, praise God, withstand your faith. That's why, amen, Peter said, resist him steadfast in the faith. Devil is a roaring lion, but when he come against you, you resist him steadfast in faith. Yeah. I mean, you, what when that lion come in, you resist it. Lion, you got a shield on, shield of faith. Nothing can, amen, harm you, Lord, you have a shield on. Yeah. Lord, you really believe God, no devil in hell can defeat you, praise God. Yeah. Amen, ain't no devil do you no harm, Lord, you believe God, amen. Lord, you got that shield on, praise God. Everybody said the shield is quick, y'all the father, amen, and you ain't got to worry about the wicked stuff. See, you're praying that, amen, praise God. The number one thing you must learn to do is defeat your enemy. You can all defeat him in faith. Can you say amen again? Once you get him defeated, then you don't have to worry about it. If you say, well, I want to move all the living stones. Like you get there when you defeat liquor, get victory over it. When your faith rises up and you conquer that spirit, amen, of lust that making you drink the stuff. Yeah. They can set liquor all around you, you ain't gonna drink it. Yeah. Why? Because you've been delivered, set free from the stuff. Can you say that again? So that is the way with anything in life, amen, praise God, that is, amen. And this is what Paul said in the spirit of weakness. It doesn't matter what it is, lust or whatever, praise God. As long as you have faith, you have power over it. The reason why, praise God, that you lose victory is because you lose faith first. Right? Amen. When you take down, amen, and start doing what you ought not to be doing, that means you lost faith. You lost victory. You lost faith. You started to unbelieve God in it. You didn't believe that you could stand. But long as you believe that you can stand, it doesn't matter what it is. You can make it. Amen. Amen. But when you stop believing, amen, the children of Israel could not go on because they stopped believing in God. They stopped believing in miracles. Stopped believing in God. They started saying, can God fund it? Can God make a way? Can God prepare a table in the wilderness? Can God give us meat to eat? You understand? Put a limit on God. Put a limit on the Holy One. See, unbelief and doubt, put a limit on God. But faith takes the limit off of God. Faith makes you believe that nobody was, no girl than you are. You can have what anybody else got. That's what your faith makes you. That faith makes you, my God, rise up and you, my God, you ain't got a dime. You believe you're going to get some. Hallelujah. See, that way faith rises. When it wants to rise up, praise God, it makes you feel like, hey, man, feel like you're somebody. You know, unbelief makes you feel like you ain't nobody. Everybody running over you. Everybody walking on you. Everybody mistreating you. But faith, amen, you walk out there, brother, amen, you're a couple. Yeah. You're coming everything. Amen. You don't care what them folks think about you. Amen. You don't care what they look like, and praise God. You're not afraid of them because you believe your God was able. Your God is able to fix things and bless you. I'm going right. Oh my God, amen. I'm getting ahead. Oh, I know they're looking on me. Ain't worried about me. You know, amen. One day you're gonna rise on top.